My name is Captain O'Neill V. Deer. I am from Mumbai. I am working as Deputy General Manager in Varun Shipping, Bombay. Hari Om. This occasion on 26th of May, which was announced primarily Nahao Tujha Prem. We were waiting for it for almost couple of months for this big occasion to happen. To be very frank, for me, who was a quite late entrant into Bapu's fold, for me, it was first big such occasion. And I had no expectations, but at the same time, there was a feeling of looking forward to something unknown. And there was inner craving, something like a sweetness you crave for, but it couldn't be explained. There was also a doubt in my mind that all these abhangs and devotional songs are going to be in Marathi, whether I'll be able to sit through for 5-6 hours. But as Bapu Bhakta or Bapu's Kripa, he always fine-tunes you, brings you around, so much so, a day before, my wife, she had a severe backache and her legs were swollen, and she expressed her inability to sit through for so long. We just did naman to Bapu, that Bapu, it is only your kripa, please see it, how we are able to go through this whole thing. And finally the day arrived, we reached the stadium around 4 o'clock. The first and foremost thing, I mean, the crowd which was there and the way it was being managed so well, even parking and other things, and the way we were led through, and there was a sense of love all around. That was something very unique. And then when the final hour came, when this thing started at 4 o'clock, Bapu, I and Dada, when they came on the stage, there was a loud applause. And when we looked around, there were people all around as if it was some super IPL final going to happen. And to my mind, the thought which crossed my mind was, this is even beaten IPL final, because the dedication, the devotion, and then the abhanga started. For some reason, throughout this whole thing, I never felt that I am a non-Maharashtrian. Everything was just penetrating into me. When there was time, I was rising up, applauding, jumping around, you know, in ecstasy. And there were no fetters, there was no hesitation to express your joy. And there were large screens when Bapu used to sometimes raise his hand to his mouth and, you know, spread his love and affection. It was so contagious that the whole stadium used to get alight with love. I would only say that this love was so permeating that when we met each and every person, they were all full of love. I mean, there was only one unique thing which was pervasive all around, was love. There was no other bhav in anybody else. People were more than willing to help each other, accommodate each other, and with having such a big crowd and not a single push is amazing. I mean, there's nobody to tell you on the disciplinary aspect, but it was happening so natural because there was so much respect, love, devotion, and that only what has transmuted from our Bapu to all the Shraddhavans from every spectra of life, from every walk of life, so much so when at the final hour when Bapu, I and Dada went on the stage, and they gave their blessings to all the Shraddhavans around, there were suddenly droplets from the air. I thought, wow, our Bapu's trust has done a wonderful job. This time some helicopter is going up and is sprinkling water. It was something like in the mandir how people sprinkle water. And suddenly I looked up, there were no helicopter or anybody. It was just showering, and there was a so much sense of heave from everybody, as if it was divine blessings from the heaven. And everybody felt thoroughly on each and every part of the body. And when I looked around and I stepped out of the stadium, there was not a drop outside the stadium. And probably it must have happened for 30 seconds or 60 seconds, as if it was heavenly blessing. So the truth, what Bapu talks of truth, joy and love, these three things were very much visible, and we could feel innermost in our heart. And the most amazing thing I will tell you, while walking out, imagine 40,000 people coming out from various gates. In between there were a couple of cars which were stuck, and it looked so many people. And we had a inkling as if there could be a stampede. But the beauty of Bapu Bhaktas and Bapu's divine grace is not a single person was even touching each other or even pushing. People were just accommodating and giving way to everybody else. It was just amazing. And thereafter, when I landed up in a nearby fast food restaurant, there I saw people coming from far and wide. Somebody coming from Ahmednagar, somebody coming from people coming from Bangalore, and just one conviction that whatever our Bapu is doing for us, this today was our dedication and devotion, and to say, Bapu, we love you, and kindly always hold us at your feet. We surrender at your holy lotus feet. Please, 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 don't let us ever be away, even for a blink. Bapu, we love you, and we always love you. These are the only thoughts which come out in the form of pure love. Hari Om.